How would you describe your state of health?
So far, wala naman akong nararamdamang kakaiba. My blood pressure is normal, my heartbeat is normal. I play golf once a week.
Have you had any major surgery, a minor
wala
surgery?
Wala po.
Maintenance medicines?
Wala rin po.
Vitamins?
I drink coffee when it's very hot. Pag lumamig siya ng konti, ayaw ko na. Ganun din sa sigarilyo.
State of wealth.
My state of wealth, I am rich but I am not liquid. Kasi over the years, no, sa media work, alam naman ang lahat na I've been there once, no, on top sa as a broadcaster. So nakapag-ipon-ipon naman, nakabili ng konting ari-arian for myself and for my kids. Kaya lang, mayaman ka doon sa fixed assets, no. Hindi ka ganun ka-liquid. Yung Vice Presidente po sa atin sa Pilipinas, sa pananaw ko, dapat hindi lang siya Vice Presidente. In fact, the politically correct term should be President in waiting sa pananaw ko. Because remember, sa Pilipinas, the President and the Vice President they get their mandate directly from the people. Unlike in many other countries, yung boto sa Presidente, automatic boto ng Vice Presidente. That, pwede siyang maging spare time. Kasi, kumbaga, binoto lang siya para spare time. Sa ating kasi, parehong inaatasan ng tao na tingnan kung ano makakabuti para sa bansa. And therefore, ang talaga kong sinasabi, yung vice presidente dapat kasing galing o hindi man mas magaling pa sa presidente. So that in the event that kailangan niyang mga siwa directly, ready siya.
Will you ask for a cabinet position, sir, and which one?
The matter of asking, hindi po siguro. That would come from the president siguro.
Will you be a high-profile vice president or just stay in the shadows?
Ewan ko kung kailangan pa yun. Because una-una, I have been a high-profile. We're talking of yung, kasi marami kasi ang magiging nangyayari. Maraming masyadong pumapapel. Ako siguro, kasi pag gumagawa ka ng mabuti, at saka ginagawa mo yung trabaho mo, hindi ka na kinakailangan mag-high profile. My role would be to advise the president, to counsel the president, to monitor the bureaucracy, if it's functioning according to what the people need and what they want. Ngayon, pag hindi, it is also my duty as an elected vice president to keep the people informed of what goes on in government.
Sir, will you be a traveling vice president?
Yeah. We go by tradition. Usually in the olden times, if I remember right, the vice president usually is kept away from Malacañang. Kaya nga palaging inaapoint ng vice presidente na secretary of foreign affairs so that he doesn't have the time to meddle the affairs of the administration para hindi mo nasisilip. More often than not, the president would delegate some ministerial work to the vice president. So yung mga trabahong gano'n, mahirap din tanggihan yung utos ng presidente. No? So titingnan po natin kung how the working relationship will go after the first meeting with the president, with his president-elect. If at all, if it may serve the country any better. I think, kasi dun sa isang program ako, is we have to re-engineer kasi our foreign service. You have 8 to 10 million Filipino nationals abroad, whether permanent resident, migrant workers, iba-iba, no? Documented and undocumented Filipinos. Ang nangyayari po kasi, doon sa nakalipas ng mga panahon, sa kagustuhan natin na makapagbigay ng oportunidad ng makapagtrabaho yung Pilipino po, pag nakakatanggap tayo ng job orders from other countries, ano kagad eh, we grab the opportunity eh. To me, while there is nothing wrong with grabbing the opportunity, dapat isecure mo muna yung welfare ng migrant workers. So, a bilateral labor agreement must be put in place before we deploy any Filipinos, kung doon sa punto yung I need to travel, I would. Because we have to serve these 8 to 10 million Filipinos who incidentally contributes 32% of our national economy. Erap did not resign. Erap did not step down. Remember, the record will show that even the Supreme Court says Gloria is only sworn as acting president. In fact, that's the reason I stopped teaching, because I cannot explain to my student the presumption of resignation. We cannot have a constructive resignation. Constructive resignation, as a matter of fact, if we follow the labor law, is not amount to illegal dismissal.
I end up hired then, asking you to take over from President Arroyo. You wouldn't have agreed to likewise.
I will not be dictated upon by a few people who claims to be representing the entire Philippine social strata to do something illegal, illegitimate, unconstitutional. Ako ang man of law. You know, laws are there to be respected. You do not dismiss a president who is elected by the people. It is the people who will dismiss the president in a constitutional process that is a recall. Ang tinatakbo ko, vice presidente, siyam yung tumatakbong presidente, lahat sila, kandidato ko. Because whoever wins, I will have to work with them if I am given the mandate by the people.
You and the elected president will talk from different parties. Yes. What will your role be?
My role will be Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines. I don't think I will ever have a problem working with any one of them. Let us say, si Gibo ang manalo at kailangan niya ng matinong vice presidente, matalinong vice presidente. Ako naman, my record will speak that I'm educationally prepared for the position. If Dick Gordon makes it, pareho kami crisis manager. If Villar makes it, wala rin akong problema, because I have worked with a good Senate president for the longest time. Siguro magandang combination, because here comes isang tao na lumaki galing sa hirap sa syudad, isang na nagsikap, umasenso. Ako galing sa rural setting. Si Erap naman, wala rin akong makitang problema kay Erap, kasi ang biro ko nga ho eh, maswerte ang Pilipinas pag si Erap nanalo, ako isi. Dahil dalawang presidente ng bansa, isang pang-aral, isang pang-galing. Si Noeloy, hindi po kakaiba sa pamilya namin. Ako kasi wala akong problema sa pakikibagay eh.
Are you not discouraged by
serving? Not at all. 50 million ang butante. Ang base nila, on the average, 1,200. Palagay mo na 2,000. That's only 0.004% of the voting population. How can it represent? Simple arithmetic. Kahit sinong nagbinegosyo o sinong nagkukwenta, yung wala pang 1% will never represent anything.
Realistically, how do you rate your win chances and scale of 1 to 10?
I am hopeful, but I'm not expecting.
1 to 10.
Mahirap eh. You never know what goes into the mind of an electorate until he feeds his ballot to the people's machine. Alam mo what inspires me to run? Number one, the people of Mindanao, palagi nila sinasabi na napapabayaan tayo. I called for one Mindanao vote. Sabi ko, with 11.8 million as of March 2010, there is no way a Mindanao candidate will lose a national election if we only rally as one. Kasi kako, ito lang ang pagkakataon natin. Sinasabi natin, inaalipusta tayo. And yet, pag merong electoral process, ang binoboto natin, yung mga tao rin ang aalipusta sa atin.